Now, what do you do here to keep all of that alive, to remember those souls that were here and played an important and integral part in the settlement of our great state?
Well, one thing that we do is we always make people go, or try and get them to go to the cemetery. Because the night after this happened, they buried the bodies of the five men in shallow graves and took off. And I'm amazed that they even took the time to do that, but they did. And they left, and then they told the soldiers at Fort Houston near Palestine, there were 500 to 700 Comanche Kiowa warriors. And of course the soldiers kind of doubted that, because no one had seen that large a group of Indians together in a long time. So when they came back, it took them 2 weeks to walk over there, so immediately the soldiers were dispatched and they came back in one day, and they found body parts everywhere, and they didn't know if the Indians came back and dismembered them or if they were dug up by animals. 2 weeks is a long time. And so they took those parts and they put them all in a wagon, and they left the fort, and this was all prairie land at the time, and they went to the largest oak tree from the southwest corner of the fort again and buried them so that they could tell the people they were buried under this large oak tree. And that was the beginning of Fort Parker Memorial Park.
My goodness.
And so we have there, over there, we have a monument, and it took 10 years going through Congress and the United States government to get this monument put up to, you know, immortalize these people that were pioneers, that were brave enough to come here. And they were worried that Quanah Parker and the Indians wouldn't like the monument, but they said, do it. Do it. And they gave the blessing, and then they were allowed to put this large monument up.